Neil Hill, Tosh, welcome to Video Celts. How did you enjoy your time at the Masters tonight?
It was great, Joe. I really hung the boots up, but because of lack of numbers, then I get roped into it again this year. But it's always good to take part, see old pals, and beat the Rangers.
Why did you hang the boots up?
Ah, well, 45, 46 my next birthday, so it's all over for me, Joe.
Seriously, you haven't changed facially or too much timber?
Well, you try and keep yourself fit, but obviously it's when you come to play tournaments like that's when you find out your real fitness. It's hard work out there, but as I say, it's good to see the boys. Good win against Rangers, but unlucky against Middlesbrough.
That's only twice you said a good win against Rangers.
Well, that's it. It's always good to beat the Rangers.
So was your game, the Tommy Burns match, was that your final appearance ever at Celtic Park, do you reckon?
Well, I think on so. The park? I think so. Hopefully it's not for an occasion like that, but if it's a testimonial and get the old crocs back, then you're always tempted. But it means training for like 4 or 5 months just to get one game in, so you always try to keep ticking over. But as I say, it's when you get out there and find out your real fitness against guys maybe 10 or 15 years younger than you.
What's it like catching up with some of the boys again? And
well, that's it. It's a dressing room banter, Joe, and it's fantastic to see all the old crew. I had a good time with wee Eddie in that left-hand side in the Burns years, so it's good to see him, Kieran, Goals, Boydie, Chick Charlie. It's good to see the old crew again.
What said before a game against Rangers at this level, it's very friendly. I see chat with Stuart McCall and a few others. It's not quite the same intensity, but
well, if you play Rangers at Tiddlywinks, you want to beat them. So I think the saving grace in the tournament is we beat Rangers 3-2. That's about 3 or 4 times I've said it now. But it's great to get the old rivalry back again. Plus, when you step onto the pitch, whatever level it's at, 5-a-sides, 11-a-sides, you obviously want to win.
So that's you hanging up with trainers in the high?
Well, I'd said that last year, but maybe I'll be back. But if the numbers are back and the big hitters are back, then I'll probably find myself on the bench again. But you never know.
We enjoyed your appearances on Celtic TV. The pinstripes, the fantastic ties. You're not quite as elegant this evening, but
well,
what have you been up to? We haven't seen too much since the end of Celtic TV.
Well, the Celtic TV went to the wall. I was really enjoying that, but obviously with Satanta going busted.
You're a bit of a jinx.
Sorry?
You're a jinx.
Well, it ended up, as I say, I was enjoying it, but that went to the wall. So I've really been spending my time developing my plot up at Eastwood Bride, so that's what I'm going to do.
You're a property tycoon.
Well, I don't say that, but certainly that's what I enjoy, a bit of labour, grafting in with the workers, so that's what I'm doing from day to day.
And you're still watching Celtic as much as you can?
Absolutely, it's my club. I was lucky enough to play for the Hoops as well, so I monitor it and obviously hoping they get the championship back this year.
What's the expectations for Neil Lennon as manager, is it?
Well, first and foremost, when you go into the job, I think the criteria is you must do well and try and win the championship. It's obviously going to be very difficult. Finances have been curtailed over the past couple of years. But Celtic have got a strong squad, so you would probably hope that they go and at least compete with Rangers and try and get this flag back.
What was the score again tonight, Tosh?
Celtic 3, Rangers 2.
Cheers.